great. This is great. You have full screen, and you can see us in the room at ETH.
I saw you before. I'm right now in the Nimaga application, so I can hear you but not see you.
Okay. But so that you know, you're talking to about 25, 30 people here in the room at ETH. All of us are future entrepreneurs. And I already said a few words about you, Dominik. It's super special to have you because, first of all, of course, you've been an employee of one of the greatest companies, Venturelab. Then you started maybe an equally amazing company, Procedural, with ETH people. And then you sold it off to Esri, which is quite impressive. And we are here to learn from you, Dominik. The stage is yours.
Good. Thank you very much for the kind introduction, Raphael, and hello from sunny California. And this is very exciting for me because, as Raphael just said, about 20 years ago, I was actually part of the original Venturelab crew. And that means we won this big $60 million Swiss franc RFP from the Swiss government to create the national Swiss startup initiative, Venturelab. And as you can see on the slide, I was probably in every university and University of Applied Science in Switzerland to promote entrepreneurship when it was not so cool. But these days, as I can see, I think all the cool people are having startups, and thanks for having me. Therefore, I want to give you back in the next 45 minutes, and we will start with the foundation. How has sales changed and what are the new roles? Because the old ways of sales aren't working like they used to. Then we will discuss different winning sales mindsets and why sales confidence is especially important for technical first-time entrepreneurs. And finally, and this is very exciting, I will show you a step-by-step process how you can win your first dream customers. Does this sound exciting? Okay, now let's get started with the fun stuff. So I love startups, and startups are my passions. Since I can think, I was always an entrepreneur, I was creating something. And my last startup was an ETH spin-off called Procedural that we sold to Esri in 2011. I also wrote the Startup Secrets Blackbook that covers 7-step workflow to test any idea fast. And today I live in beautiful California, and by day I lead a global sales team for smart cities at Esri. And by night, since I don't hardly watch any TV, don't have Netflix or any social media, I help companies with sales coaching on my platforms, salesintheusa.com or wininTheUSA.com. I also invest in startups, and I'm on the board of the Swiss American Chamber of Commerce in LA. And in the last 25 years, I had the really rare opportunity to work with hundreds of the smartest and most successful startups, as well as entrepreneurs and even billionaires around the world in every market you can dream of. I co-founded the Procedural, an ETH spin-off, made it profitable within 3 years, and then sold it to Esri, one of the biggest private software companies in the world. And through my journey, I really discovered the secret how to scale sales. And that is exactly what I will share with you today. But let's start first with the foundation. So sales has changed. The old ways of sales aren't working like they used to. And what is actually changing? So did you know that the average human attention span is about 8.25 seconds? This is even less than a goldfish. The attention span of an average goldfish is about 9 seconds. And research shows that the use of the smartphones and social media really destroys more and more our attention spans. By the way, did you know that 93% of all the B2B buying processes start with an online search? So buyers are mainly looking for information in the buying process, and then definitely trust. And all the big B2B deals that I've won in my life were extremely complex, took a long time, and had on average 6 to 10 people involved. So goodbye to the traditional door salesman or car sales guy sales approach. And did you know that 8 out of 10 sales happen after the fifth contact? So we have to do a few things 1,000 times instead of doing 1,000 things a few times. And the best and the biggest companies in the world are very aware of these stats, and they are relentless in their follow-ups, because the fortune is in the follow-ups and only amateurs focus on the first sale. And you're certainly aware that in business, there are basically two modes. You either grow fast or die slow, based on this McKinsey's finding. Growth, for example, matters more than margin or cost structure, and growth even predicts long-term success. And that was definitely the case for my startup Procedural. So in 2008, I co-founded the ETH spin-off Procedural, and we were developing and selling a software called CityEngine that you can see on the screen that create virtual 3D cities faster than any other software on the planet, based on a procedural modeling technology developed at ETH. And we had big dreams. We planned to release in total 4 products with 3 financing rounds to become operationally break even at the end of 2010. Good planning, right? But very bad timing. So on September 15, 2008, the Lehman collapse sent a shockwave around the world. And from one day to another, it was basically impossible to raise any money. So we had to drastically adjust our plan, as you can see here on the slide. But the only thing that we actually achieved was being operationally break even in year 3 because of our successful sales system that I will share with you today. But before, let's talk about sales confidence. Sales confidence is a key factor for your business success, especially for first-time entrepreneurs or entrepreneurs that don't like sales at all. If you have the winning sales confidence mindset, you will transform your sales and everything will just feel better. Sales confidence will even help you to overcome procrastination regarding your sales activities. Now, one of the most famous last words from entrepreneurs are, "We build it, now they will come." No, totally wrong. Big, big mistake. The biggest problem that most entrepreneurs have isn't creating an amazing product or service. It's getting their future customers to discover that they even exist. Because the business killer number one is low to no sales. And strong sales, I promise you, will change everything. Imagine 2 companies that open on the same block in 1967. One was Joe's Hamburger Joint, a nice, lovely mom and pop shop that puts in a lot of love and admiration in every hamburger, and the other one is McDonald's. 60 years later, McDonald's is the highest grossing hamburger restaurant in the world, while Joe's Hamburger still only has 1 location. Now, which company do you think has the better tasting burgers? Well, if you have ever been to McDonald's, you might know the answer. So sales really trumps all. And make no mistakes. The first sales force is actually you. The founder or the founders will have to sell every day, at least in the beginning. Therefore, sales confidence is so important, because sales is actually hard. And you might ask, yeah, how hard actually? Be prepared to be rejected most of the time, about 70% of the time. Therefore, the best salespeople in the world are those with high dominance and strong self-confidence. Or do you really think Steve Jobs was a wallflower? So strong confidence is key. And you might now think, I get it, Dominik. I have to have strong confidence, but this is just not possible for me. I'm just not that kind of guy. Now, you might be not a natural salesperson. I agree with that. But it's not impossible for you. So allow me to introduce you to Napoleon Hill. So Napoleon Hill is probably America's most beloved motivational author. His best-selling book, Think and Grow Rich, was sold over 20 million times, which makes it the all-time bestseller in the field. And one of his most famous quotes is actually, whatever the mind can conceive and believe, the mind can achieve. Now you might say, yeah, nice statement, but this is woo-woo talk and definitely not reality. Okay, got it. Please let me introduce you then to Simon Hagler. So Simon, the person in the middle with the red circle, is a senior software engineer and got his PhD actually from ETH. So he was one of the founding member of my startup Procedural and still to this date, a great friend and colleague at Esri. And back in 2008, we had the chance to participate in a big international project called Rome Reborn. And Rome Reborn was a project that recreated Rome virtually in 3D in the year 300 before Christ. And this was a very prestigious project and different global players like IBM, Nvidia, Google, etc. were involved. And our task as Procedural was to generate with our software CityEngine thousands and thousands of buildings. But in return, we would get a free booth at the famous computer graphics conference, SIGGRAPH in Los Angeles. And since this was a huge opportunity for us, we had to have all hands on deck and everybody in the team went through sales training, even our software engineer, and you guessed it right, also Simon, our ETH PhD software engineer. And beside our own sales training and preparation, we also engaged a wonderful sales coach called Christian Engler. And that helped us to bring the training to the next level with role play, group discussion, and creating a sales confidence that led actually to a huge success for Simon. So Simon sold on the SIGGRAPH show floor software for several thousand dollars. And on the picture, you can see Simon with the signed contract. So if Simon can do it, do you still think it's impossible for you to create sales confidence? But let's analyze for a second what actually happened here. First, I think we all underestimate the power of self-fulfilling prophecy. And a self-fulfilling prophecy is a belief or an expectation, could be correct or incorrect, that can bring a desired or expected outcome. And there is actually a lot of research about self-fulfilling prophecy in case you want to look it up. But back to Simon. We created a plan or a system how to make sales at SIGGRAPH. Thanks to that, he grew his confidence. Based on his confidence, he took action, trained for it, and was part of our SIGGRAPH Boost team. He was very disciplined and practiced what he learned over and over. And instead of doing a thousand things a few times, he actually did just one thing, but a thousand times. Simple, but not easy. But what Simon definitely not did was he had doubts. So he never doubted himself, because the only thing that can be happen if you don't have strong self-confidence is like you're doubting yourself. And that just makes everything harder. So let's give you some ideas about mindset, how you can use it. And let's imagine you want to go actually to a sales conference. And why don't you just set yourself up in a positive feedback loop with the sentence, it can be sold. Whenever you have negative or critical thoughts or doubt yourself, then just refuse it and repeat the sentence, it can be sold. It can be sold. It can be sold. How about an important presentation in front of a lot of people? Use before the presentation or whenever you get nervous, the mindset, they will just love it. This will be so amazing. Or if you like a certain song that really pumps you up or gives you confidence, you can use that as well before the presentation. And you feel your whole perception and sentiment towards the presentation will completely change with such mindset. What about an important investor presentation? Again, instead of just doubting yourself, repeat, this is exciting. I'm privileged actually to present my startup to potential investor, and they might even give me money so that I can fulfill my dream. How awesome is this? And I will give 100%. I'm all in to make this happen. Do you think this will make a difference for your investor presentation? For sure, right? And finally, a pro tip, you might want to try to write down your long-term goals or big dreams in life down and visualize it. Visualize it and then read it twice a day. Once after you just woke up and once before you go to bed. Do that for at least 3 months and then tell me what happened. I could imagine that you will be surprised with the outcome. Now, this is very exciting. I will show you now how you can win your first dream customer, even if you have never done it before, being frustrated about sales or even hate sales. But first, we have to understand that you are today where your best thinking or your current sales plan have brought you. If you are happy about it, that's perfect and congrats. But if you are not growing with over 20% per year, then I respectfully suggest something new. But before we start, one word of caution from Startup Man. If you don't take action, actually nothing will happen. Try to be open and very self-reflective, because I need a commitment from you before we start, because I have done it. I've seen it over and over again that focusing on dream customers is the key to strong sales. So I don't want to have any dabblers. I need a real commitment. And the commitment is, as soon as I know that dream customers are the key for strong sales, I will go all in. Sounds good? All right. And what does going all in really means? So the squirrel right here did not go all in. It was dabbling. This guy right here, he went all in. That's what I'm talking about. Then Grumpy Cat, he's never all in, excepting Grumpiness. But this cat right here, definitely all in. What about these guys? Are they all in? Kind of, right? But the guys there, they're completely all in. And if you're all in, then it's really write down your goal in your favorite note-taking app and don't forget to add a picture, a logo, or a person. Read it twice a day. And once after you just woke up and once after you go to bed, do this for at least 3 months and you will be surprised about the outcome. This is what all in really means. Because let's be honest, business is pretty simple and mainly about two things. First, it's making dream customers know you exist. And then second, make dream customers buy from you. And it's the same for Tesla, Amazon, SpaceX, Apple. They all do the same exactly with slight differences. Some are B2B and some are B2C. But make no mistake, business is also very competitive because we are all competing about the attention or the mind space of our dream customers. Therefore, we have to know our dream customers by heart. But the reality is, however, that the majority of companies don't actually know who their dream customer is or are very unclear and not specific at all. But this is mission critical because focusing on your dream customer is the fastest, least expensive way to dramatically increase sales. And this strategy has probably helped more companies to double their sales than any other single concept. And if you don't know Chet Holmes, then I encourage you to get this book, The Ultimate Sales Machine. It's simply a must read and a deep dive into dream customers because they're always a smaller number of best buyers than they are all buyers. And the difference is really the focus. And allow me to tell you a story about focus from my previous company, Procedural. So our dream customers were Hollywood studios. And to be even more specific, Pixar was our absolute dream customer. And we developed a software called CityEngine that creates virtual cities faster than any other software in the world. So perfect for Hollywood movies. And with that in mind, we reached out to Pixar and made follow-ups like crazy, but just nothing happens. But then there was the Game Developer Conference in San Francisco. We decided to rent a nice suite close to the game developer conference, invited a whole Pixar team that was working on the blockbuster movie Cars 2 to our suite so that they could enjoy some refreshment and we could actually showcase our software CityEngine. And what you actually see here is the actual meeting with Pixar at the Game Developer Conference in San Francisco. And that meeting led Pixar to buy CityEngine and using it for the best movie of all time, Cars 2, according to my son at this time. They created around 40,000 buildings for the final London scene of the movie. And that really made a difference in the movie, but also for us. Because then, based on the publicity of this success, more and more movies like Madagascar, Superman, Transformers, Independence Day, etc., were start buying and using CityEngine. And we became cash flow positive in only 3 years. And then even I got finally acquired by Esri, my current employer, and one of the largest private software companies in the world. I lead now their global smart city business, and Procedural is now the Esri R&D center in Zurich and grew from about 15 people to about 70 people right now. And everything started with the focus on our dream customer. Now, this story has a happy end, but let's be honest, we are really facing challenging times. We see all the global turmoil, the crisis, and all the changes in the world. And it's a very competitive business landscape as well. And allow me to paint a very clear picture what the current market looks like. So only 4% of all companies in the US are surpassing $1 million in revenue. So well over 9 out of 10 businesses will never reach $1 million in sales. And then on top, almost 7 out of 10 businesses will not celebrate their 10th business birthday. And on the one side, this is just part of the nature of business, the so-called S-curve. But believe me, behind that number are also entrepreneurs with a big vision that tried their best to compete in the market. And talking about competition, Amazon has actually been like a Death Star to many traditional mom and pop stores in the USA. Amazon has currently over 3 billion, that's a B, 3 billion products competing for your dream customer's valley. And if that's not enough, then the media advertising spending in the United States alone is over $300 billion. Again, that's with the B and means you are competing with companies that are spending together over 300,000 millions to reach their dream customers. And this means sales is hard and it's getting harder and harder to reach your dream customer because there is this brutal war for attention, right? And every person in the world has only 24 hours per day to think about certain topics, idea, or things. And all businesses are actually in this competition. And all this means it's getting really hard to get the attention or reach your dream customer. And when I sometimes watch businesses competing for their dream customers, in most cases, it looks like this. They are trying sales tactics like Facebook ads, outbounds, posting free contents, LinkedIn groups, and maybe even webinars with little to no results. But then once in a while, I see a business that is acting like this. Do you see what happened there? That guy actually had a plan, was confident enough to take action, stick to the plan, and did one thing over and over. That's it. Simple, but not easy. And that is exactly also the plan for us today to win our first dream customer. And here is an overview of the system that worked for me over and over. Whether it was being in charge of sales for a startup, small and medium business, or even a huge global player. It's a two-step process. First, we have to make dream customer know we exist. And then second, we make dream customers buy from us. And every business in the world, whether it's Tesla, Amazon, SpaceX, Apple, you name it, they all do exactly the same thing with slight differences. Yes, some are business to business, some are business to consumers. But at the end of the day, it's simple, but definitely not easy. Therefore, I created this effective tool for you that will guide you through the dream customer acquisition process. It's a three-step process to transform your sales and focus you on the things that matter, your dream customer, because this is the fastest, least expensive way to increase your sales. And never forget, if you are just doing that, you are ahead of 92% of your competitors. Data shows that a whopping 92% of businesses lack a standardized sales process. So instead of having a plan and doing a few things 1,000 times in a very structured way, these companies don't have a plan and are doing 1,000 things a few times and then complain that whatever marketing or sales tool that they are using is not working. But not for you. I will walk you now through the main step of the process. Focusing on the best buyers is the fastest and least expensive way to increase sales. And there is always a smaller number of best buyers than there are all buyers. Therefore, let's get started with step number one, the who. So step number one is highlighted here in red. So we start with industry or NAICS code, which is a 5 or 6-digit classification code in America. Then we're adding headcount, annual revenue, and location, where you can get inspiration for that. These days, the number one source for me is on LinkedIn or the LinkedIn Sales Navigator. LinkedIn is the biggest business network in the world with over 700 million members in over 200 countries. And if you don't have LinkedIn Sales Navigator, feel free to get a free trial and test it out. But let's get back to our tool and complete step number one. I have chosen the software development industry, that is NAICS code 513210. I want to target big companies that I can have a huge difference or make a huge difference for my bottom line. Revenue, I don't really care, but location has to be California. Straightforward, and we're already done with step number one. That was easy. Now step number two. Step number two is all about location, 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 but it's always also about people, people, and people. People are buying from people they trust. And let me tell you a quick story. I'm currently in the market for a new heating and cooling system in my house. And my HVAC guy is for about 10 years, Nick. And he's always there for me, whether it's Sunday morning, Christmas evening, whether I'm freezing or whether it's too hot, he's always there when I need him. So I will go now with whatever he recommends me to do. Would I really care if he's a bit more expensive than a faceless discounter? No, not at all, because it's about Nick. People are buying from people they trust. So in step number two, we plug now all the data into the Link Sales Navigator that we did in step number two, number one, and under the lead account filter. So if we do that with our specification, then we're getting all the companies with our selection on the right side. And I choose now, for our example, Esri in the Sales Navigator. And if I select the company on LinkedIn, it will give me automatically the employees and key people of the company. And we can now choose the right person, our dream customer. So in our example, I've chosen myself as the global director for Smart City. After that, we do a first initial band sales qualification. That's a common standard in a sales process, like an initial qualification with budget, authority, need, and timeline. We add then the email, the physical address, and last but not least, we also want to clarify the buyer's motivation or the reason behind the reason, whether it's about money, pain, status, or career advancement. If this is hard for you to fill out, then I can recommend certain tools like a ChatGPT for the initial band. If you can find the email or the physical address, use tools like Zoom Info, Hunter.io, or just use my favorite search engine, DuckDuckGo. But most of the data that you need is publicly available over the internet. And if you can find it at all, just pick up the phone and call the main phone number of your dream customer's company and ask kindly for the information. And with that, we are already done with step number two. That was easy, right? Step number three is a main step, and it's all about getting the attention of our dream customer, as well as we are aware that there is a war for attention. And every business is in competition for the mind space of their dream customer. And there is only so much room in the average human mind. Furthermore, we only have 24 hours per day to think about certain topics, ideas, or things. So therefore, we have to be very strategic. But before we start, allow me one question. Imagine I put you in a room in front of 100 of your perfect dream customer. First question, would you be ready right now? Could you present to them and do it perfectly? I assume most people are not ready. And when they think they're ready, they will mainly talk about themselves, right? It sounds then like, this is our product, this is our feature, this is our roadmap, this is our timeline, this is our price, and so on. But what your dream customer actually would like to hear is something about their favorite person, something about themselves. And on top, there are actually two big problems when we are trying to sell our dream customer. Problem number one is nobody likes to be sold, and selling breaks rapport. When people feel sold, they will automatically resist you. So what is the solution? Education. When people are educated, they have no resistance, especially if the information is good. Problem number two, when we are direct selling, is called the buyer's pyramid. If I would ask you right now, who is in the market for a HVAC system, a car, or a laptop computer, at any time, you would have only about 3 to 10% of the people that are currently right now buying or are even open to buy. 90% are not. The majority don't even think or know that they are interested. So if I'm just selling, I'm losing immediately 90% of potential dream customer because they just don't care. Respectively, they are not in the market. So the solution is really education-based selling or marketing, because you will attract way more buyers if you're offering something to teach to them. And you will attract simply much more than just try to sell the product. But let's imagine for a second that you are able to sell with direct approach. And at the end of the day, you might have money in your pocket, but probably did not establish trust at all. So this dream customer that you just sold might be just a one-off customer with low loyalty or no long-term value. So we have to be very strategic and educate our dream customer in a first step. How can we do that? We are creating a report for sales director with amazing insights and actionable information and a catchy title like the 5 most critical insights to massively increase your sales in 2023. And the whole report could look like this with great information, nice visuals in a short report that is easy and fun to read. Nobody will feel sold. Everybody will feel educated. On the top, it will be easier for you to get meetings. It will position you immediately as an expert. And lastly, it's establishing immediately credibility for you without breaking a report. And if you like the idea of creating a report, but you are not sure what works for you best, then let me suggest a tool called Answer the Public. It's mainly compiling all the Google searches for specific keywords, and then it's compiling it 100 different ways that you actually know what people are really interested. Once you have figured out the right angle for your education-based selling or your report, then ChatGPT can really help you with the initial workload. Just tell ChatGPT or your favorite AI tool to act as an advertising director, and then feed it with a clever prompt like the one that you see here on the screen. And one last thing, after ChatGPT has done its work, I usually like to further structure my communication, and I use a tool called Message Map. And a message map is a fantastic tool, mainly a simple framework to visualize and focus my communication. And the message map, as you can see here, contains three main elements: the headline, the key points, and then supporting points. And it doesn't have to be three key points. It could be just one, or it just also could be 5 or 10, whatever fits you best. And then when we're done, you can use now the content or the report to get the attention of your dream customer. And we will talk in our next step how to actually execute it. But the methodology will enable you to ultimately establish rapport, get meetings, position you as an expert, and establish immediate credibility. What more could you ask for, right? And with that, we are ready for our final step, step number 4. So step number 4 is the how. It's the final step to win your first dream customer. And I don't know about you, but in my youth, I played a little bit chess. And I was always very impressed about how many steps that the pro chess player can think ahead. So the average amateur chess player can think 1 to 3 moves ahead. A pro can think 4 to 5 steps ahead. But then I was really blown away when I found out that masters or even grandmasters can think up to 15 moves ahead. Now, how about sales? So 8 out of 10 sales happen after the 5th contact. So like a chess grandmaster, we have to think ahead and plan our next move. It's the war about attention. It's about making people know that you even exist. And the best companies in the world, they are really the grandmasters in follow-ups. And I did a little research myself where I just recorded how many times companies are sending emails within 1 month. And you can see Amazon, 40 emails, eBay, 30 emails, Boss, the fashion brands, 24 emails, even Apple, 15 emails. And why so many emails? Because they know the fortune is in the follow-ups, and only amateurs focus on the first sales. So you have to plan for your next 12 to 15 steps ahead. Now that brings us back to our tool, to the 3rd and final step. I know that planning and system are not very exciting for everybody, but they are one of the main differences between zeros and heroes in business. And sale, at the end of the day, is all about probabilities and odds. The more moves you are ahead of your competitors, the more the odds are in your favor. So if we all agree the fortune is in the follow-ups, 82% of all sales are made after the 5th contact, and we have to plan 12 to 15 steps ahead, the only real question is then, what is the best way to reach out to our dream customers? Now, what you see here, we have here on the y-axis, the impact of an outbound, and then on the x-axis, the effort that it takes to create the outbound. So email is low effort and low impact. I think we know all that. LinkedIn is about the same. Probably the best option is personal referral or intro from a person that already know my dream customer. This would be my preferred solution. But let's face it, in most of the time, that just doesn't exist. So there is one option that takes a little bit more effort, but can have a lot of impact to get you a lot of attention. Send your dream customer every other week a clever written mailer with a smart little gift like a Rubik's Cube, a stopwatch, a compass, and so on. And what you see here are 12 templates for such letters with their respective gifts. So you can see here a stopwatch, a calculator, a Rubik's Cube, a compass, a luggage tags, and so on. And this kind of physical letters gets these days a lot of attention since we don't get so many letters anymore, right? And if you stick long enough with it, you win over just about everyone, and most importantly, your dream customer. What is the total cost of such an outbound? The total amount of all the gifts was about $30. So for the price for a nice pizza or three cafe lattes, you have the chance to get the attention of your dream customer. And I personally call this a good deal. How much time will you invest for this initial setup? If you know your industry or dream customers by heart and using services like LinkedIn Sales Navigator, ChatGPT, and Fiverr, you will initially invest a working day or between 5 to 10 hours. And what would you say? Is this worth your time when this helps you to get the attention of your dream customer? And let's be honest, what's the alternative? Facebook ads or just pure hope to get discovered by our dream customers? Again, your best thinking or your current sales plan have brought you where you are today, but you will be tomorrow where your new sales plan takes you. It can be sold, and this is very exciting. And one last word to set the right expectation. The fortune is in the follow-ups, and you are planning at least 12 steps ahead. So don't get frustrated when you don't get any reaction within the first 4 months. Don't expect anything within the first months. This is just part of the plan. Trust the process and let the system work for you. Like the guy in the money blower machine, remember? He was confident because he had a plan. He took action and had the discipline to do one thing over and over again. And then at the end of the day, he got all the money. And on top, you are just doing that. You're ahead of 92% of your competition, because a whooping 92% of businesses lack a standardized sales process. These companies are doing 1,000 things a few times and then complaining that they have spent hundreds of dollars on Facebook ads, investing tens of hours in LinkedIn content creation, or spending thousands of dollars in lead generation for leads that they have never reached out once. Don't be one of them, because even Seneca knew luck is what happens when preparation meets opportunity. Be all in and do what's right to achieve your ultimate dream. Now I wish you luck, but mainly put in the hard work. It's all about action, action, action. And never forget, it can be sold. I've seen and experienced over and over with startup, small and medium enterprises, global companies. And it's especially for you if you're totally new to all of this and don't like sales, because this is fun and will completely transform your sales, even if you think your business is completely different. Believe me, it can be sold. Now go out there and make it happen. Thank you very much. And I hand it over to you, Raphael. Can you hear me?
Wow, this is so cool. Thank you, Dominik.
Absolutely.
And I know you are also a writer. You wrote a book. Can you tell us about that?
Yeah, yes. Writing is hard, especially for me. I'm not a natural writer, but I'm very passionate about startups. So I made a playbook out of it. So it's part of entertainment. So you read through story how I was on the set of James Bond, or how I met the Kiss bass player Gene Simpson, and then I combine it with startup tools so that during basically a dinner you can read, have fun, and then you have tools to find out whether your business idea really can survive and make money. So it's less about the writing. I'm not the best writer in the world. Seneca is much better than myself. But for me, it was the passion about startups and telling in an entertaining way how you can really become really successful. Does that make sense?
Yeah, absolutely. And how can we get the book?
It's either on Amazon if you want the hard copy, or if you want to get it for free, then just go on my website, salesintheusa.com. And in the right corner, there's the free ebook where you can download and read it. And then if you want to have the hard copy, then buy it on Amazon. So I would say benefit first and get it for free as the ebook, and then get it on Amazon if you're passionate about it. And if you want to have the audiobook, just contact me and I will give you it for free. Contact me there via LinkedIn, via this QR code.
Super. Thank you so much. I think lots of people will take that offer. And I want to open the round for questions here. Who has questions for Dominik? Yes, can you come to the front and speak here, because this is...
Oh, that's hard. You guys have to make a workout, huh? To ask questions.
Good for them. Thanks a lot. Can you come over here?
Well, thanks a lot for a great presentation. One of the best I've ever heard. My question is, what you're saying, the last step is not about writing email, but get into personal contact by writing email. So forget LinkedIn, forget email, SMS, and WhatsApp, and all the social media, which is overrated. You're saying, like, so what I understand is social media kind of overrated. It's better to get in person, like, you know, brick and mortar, something, to get in contact with the customer, right? That's the way I understand, or?
Yes, absolutely. I mean, at the end of the day, you want to be a trusted advisor and a trusted person to your dream customer. Like me, in the example, I'm buying an HVAC system and Nick is my guy. I trust him. I would never change for any kind or amount of money. And that's really the fastest and least expensive way to scale sales or to even double sales, is really to create amazing relationship with your dream customers and do it over and over again. And this is a mindset. You have to really put your customer at the core, then get the attention, create a relationship. And then at the end, you will earn their business. And that's how business is done, especially if you're in big deals, in B2B deals. I'm in big B2B deals every day with Esri. And there it's all about trusted relationship. And that's what I encourage you, because I've done it for startups, for small and medium enterprises, now for global players. And it's always the same methodology with slight differences. Does that make sense?
Yeah, so that means meeting the customer physically, to build that bond, right? That's what you
want. Yes. And we all get like emails. How much bond can we produce in an email or a LinkedIn message? I mean, I get like, I don't know, 5 LinkedIn messages a day. They don't mean anything to me because I don't have any relation to that person. I don't mean that's a bad product or a bad service. It's just, it doesn't mean anything to me.
Thanks, man.
Yeah.
More questions? Yeah, can you hear the question? Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you perfectly.
Also from my side, thanks a lot for the presentation. I think it mostly focused on selling an established product and scaling a sales organization. If you think back to those years, 2008, 9, 10, I don't know when you had the first sales with Build City, I think it was, or City Build?
CityEngine.
Around the topic of product market fit, right? If you start with a technology or a problem, there is this finding process where you iterate and test and try before you can go into scaling a sales organization where it's actually more or less defined where you're going, right? Can you share with a thought what was that? Because I presume the Pixar deal was not the first deal that you made, actually, right? So I presume there was also a finding process of the first customer, maybe the second was kind of similar to the first, but it was a bit different. What your philosophies in those lines, and what helped you maybe along that journey?
Yeah, that's an amazing question. And we actually sold our first CityEngine license before we released the product. So we really understood the market well. Why? Because it was technology coming out of ETH. And you guys, if you're at ETH, you have this huge benefit because everybody's respecting ETH so much. And then you just get in contact with a lot of researcher. You're immediately in a global kind of context. And then it's just talking about it. So the methodology that I showed you works the same if you have a prototype, a pilot, or you have $100,000 already in sales. It's about establishing a connection with the potential buyer, get their trust, understanding what's going on, and then you will earn their business. So what kind of product are you doing? What's your product?
B2B SaaS product, a voice bot for the telephony environment.
Okay. Same there, right? I mean, at the end of the day, you have to reach out to CIOs. You have to understand where they are, what's their current business environment. Then you have to get the attention of them, time of them. You have to integrate all the project teams. And then you're in a B2B sales process. I'm very familiar with that. I'm doing that every day. So same process, same methodology. And if you want to talk more in detail, then happy to do so via LinkedIn.
Okay, thanks.
Good.
Hi, Dominik. This is Ivan here.
Hey.
Yeah. First of all, thank you for your time and your efforts and your passions to help staff. Thanks a lot.
Absolutely. You're welcome. Right.
So we develop a extremely light and compact personal electric vehicles for smart cities. So that's our project. And I have
Send me your information. That's exactly what we are in the same business.
Right. I'm already starting selling myself now.
Say it again.
I'm already selling myself to you now.
That's good. That's perfect. That's good. You have my attention now.
Great. Yeah. So I just need you to buy.
Yes.
So jokes aside, I have a question related to sales. I want to have your opinion on direct sales versus to sell through a third party sales channel. And the other question is, if we wanted to work with a franchise or other third parties, what are the pitfalls and what should we watch out?
Yeah. So the first question was either you should sell direct or via a partner. And that's a case-by-case scenario. So there, for example, at Esri in the US, we are selling direct. So we are the sales force. We are doing everything ourselves. In all the other countries, we have so-called distributors. So that their own entities and they're selling for us. And we are getting a cut of what they're doing. Why? Because it's just very expensive. If you really want to sell locally in every country of the world, it's really expensive. Think about the sales force that Microsoft or Google or all these other guys have. It's really expensive to sell globally and then also localize it. So that's number one. It's a case-by-case decision. And you might end up with a mixture that you say, I want to sell certain markets and other I'm open to do that. With Procedural, we had the same. We gave like exclusive kind of licenses out there for certain parts. For example, with Japan, we had an amazing distributor in Japan that was selling for us. Why? Because there was a language barrier and we just didn't know the market. Right. So that was the first question. The second question was?
If we decided to take a third party partner, what are the pitfalls and what to watch out?
What to watch out? Yeah. Do you trust them? It's pretty simple.
Okay.
Can you make a handshake agreement with somebody or is it a 200-page contract. So at the end of the day, and I see that with our distributors, again, it's about people. You have to deal with people. You have to understand. And if you don't feel comfortable or don't trust these people, don't do it. It's pretty simple. It's straightforward.
Okay. Thanks a lot.
You're welcome.
Wow. That's a great. More questions?
So, then I would like to ask a question because, I mean, you are Swiss, you moved to the US, you really learned your game over there and you've been successful. Can you tell us a little bit about the differences that you've seen selling in Europe versus selling USA and other markets?
That's such a good question. That's such a good question. So I think where US and Europe are the same or on the same level is like technology. So technology is about the same. You guys have just fantastic technology. Then on the people side, it's also you have amazing people in Switzerland, especially on the technological side, and people wise, it's also the same. I think the biggest difference is the culture about how to sell. I was once at a conference in Germany and there was like, I wanted to go to the CEO back in the booth and I had to go through, and I'm not lying here, I have to go through three people to get to then finally come to the big boss that I could really approach. If you want to get in contact with my boss and the owner and one of the richest Americans, Jack Dangerman, you write him an email and he will send you back. You can approach him everywhere that you want to. So the culture is really a very focused sales culture. It's a brutal market. Don't get me wrong. It's not all nicey-nicey. It's very focused and very driven. But you get to people very, very fast. But then you have to be also very fast. You had not to talk about you. You have to tell them how you can bring them forward. What's in it for them, instead of telling, this is our product, this is the price, this is the roadmap. No, it's not. You can, with our product, achieve this and that. With our product, you will increase your rates, blah, blah, blah. So you're talking from a different perspective. And I think that's a cultural kind of thing. Also, like, Americans are all immigrants, right? So basically the bravest people from Europe came over with the ship over to America, took like a journey of, I don't know, 2 months, almost died, and then started a completely new life. So these are the people who are now in America. And these are very, I would say, brave, innovative, and kind of entrepreneur-like people. In Switzerland, and I love Switzerland, don't get me wrong, I'm like 4 or 5 times, I'm the biggest Swiss fan, therefore I'm also in the Swiss American Chamber. I love Switzerland over everything. But you don't get credit if you're trying out different things. In Switzerland, you get credit if you're doing your stuff right over and over again. Nothing wrong about that, but that's not mainly the thing that you need in startups or entrepreneurship. Can you change that? Yes, easily. We talked about it with mindsets, with understanding what's going on inside of you, and then having like this positive reinforcement and this feedback loop. So you can actually definitely do it. And I would love to be a part of that journey. So if you have any more questions or anything, please contact me and I will help you as much as I can. Go on my website, salesintheusa.com. Currently, just download the free ebook down. And then at the end of the year, I will also open up a sales membership where I document everything with videos and tools and everything, so that everybody, whether it's startup, small and medium sized business or global players, can just educate themselves. And then I'm doing personal coaching in Las Vegas. That's not for startups because it costs a lot of money, but that's actually a day just sales training. And we're going through what I just showed you. And the aim is really to double sales. And if you are not too busy in January, I will suggest that you are coming to Las Vegas at the CES. That's the Consumer Electronics Show, the biggest tech show in the world, or even in Las Vegas. And that's really where you can meet all the investors. There is a big Swiss booth. I will be there. So that would be an amazing thing. Just book a flight with Edelweiss. I think it's about $1,000. And then you can get a ticket for free at CES and get an Airbnb for $500 and then eat for $500 for $2,000. You have the chance to meet all your dream customer, investors, and even some partners. So that would be my final recommendation.
Thank you so much. This is a great closing. Applause for Dominik.
Good. Have a great evening, and thanks, and let's connect on LinkedIn.